Hello and welcome to Babushka Land. Today we're going to fix up this garden. See this? There's all this extra green space. We're going to fill that up with some nice medieval looking patterns. And yeah, make it pretty. We're going to make this garden great again. Not really again because it was never great before this, but yeah, we're going to improve this guy. So that's the top view. Recently, I've been looking at a lot of medieval constructions on Google. I kind of like this whole like geometric pattern garden thing that all of these old buildings and estates have in them. So we're going to work on that here. Let's get to it. So I'm going to start off by outlining the areas that I want to work on. Go two out. And we'll go two from here. One, two, three. Let's go over up to there. Two, two. There we go. It's good. This way, this way, this way. Now, if I'm walking around and through here, I wouldn't mind an entrance that goes past here. The other two there. So we got like one, two, three, one, two, three. Yeah, that's perfect. So two, one, two. Just so that it's accessible, you know? Accessibility is definitely key. And we've got these two as well. Then, as far as this part goes, this isn't as wide, so I think I'll just let this be the path and not make a path through there. And over here, obviously, we've got two. Right? One, two, and go. Probably just going to follow this. Original pattern here. Two, two. Yeah, I think that makes sense. Let's take a look at it from the top. All right, so that's how it currently looks. I think it makes a lot of sense. So for the original part of this garden with these flower areas here, I was using only flowers that are two blocks high. So I think I will still use flowers that are two blocks high, especially around the outside edges, like there and there. Over here, we're going to do some triangles and then maybe do some sort of circular shape in the middle. I might grow a cherry tree there, or I might grow it in the corner over here. I'm not totally sure yet. And we'll fill in these inside bushes. And then I'm going to scatter some of these nice pink petals around the general area through like the areas that you can walk through. Okay, let's do this. Yeah, so I definitely like this L shape opening that I've got on the other side there. I'm going to continue that here, just like so. Is that even right? I don't think that's right. Is that right? No, I'm not sure if I'll be able to do it at all. We'll take a look at how this like one line looks from the top and take a look at how that L shape looks from the top as well. So I'll do this side with the L, or I'll do this side with the line, and I'll do this side with the L. So, what the fuck is this? Xbox platform notice? The fuck? I had to Google this shit. Okay, so I just Googled this Xbox platform notice. Xbox wants all children using Xbox to be safe. We entered into a settlement with the Federal Trade Commission to resolve allegations we impromptu collected data from children. If you have a child that is using Xbox, please use this link. Blah, 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 family account. I don't know, guys. Maybe if we're already paying for your product, you shouldn't collect extra data on us since we've paid for your product. Just a thought, you know, just a thought. So it obviously looks better this way. I definitely want to grow a tree in the middle there, so I'm probably going to use those polished andesite stairs to make some sort of pattern that fits inside there. And I'll do the exact same pattern on the other side as well. And then in the corners, I guess I can just start throwing some flowers down right now. I probably need more glowstone too. I can work on that glowstone later. I guess that's the amount of room that I do have. So maybe I'll elevate this. I'll put some dirt higher up. And then I'm going to put a cherry tree in this corner and put some other stuff here, maybe like a glowstone there. That's pretty cool. So this one's not so wide, so if I do anything here, it has to be pretty thin. Okay, the reason I'm leaving one block empty is so that this one turns green so that the grass spreads from there to here. Now I'm going to go and try and build the same sort of pattern on the other side. So let me just do some counting here. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Yeah, cool. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Right, so this side is going to have a bit of a bigger gap than the other side. Because, well, this seawall extends out further. Problem number one. And problem number two, my whole castle thing was uneven in the first place. So I chose to have the ground come out here from this point evenly. I think that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And I think it's 11 on the other side as well, but. Yeah, so we're going with that. Yeah, kind of works, right? Kind of works. I think that one in the center there is a little awkward, but yeah, we can improve this. We can see. There we go. One more. Skip two. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4. I kind of like this half moon idea. I'm going to put one here. Okay, I'm definitely going to go with this pattern. I like the left side better than the right side right now, so I'm going to get rid of that elevated part in the top right corner. And then I'm definitely going to go with those half circles in front of Poseidon on the left. So I'm going to go half circle, half circle, half. Yeah, we're going to do a whole front line of half circles. Maybe I'll put something elevated in the center, but honestly, probably not. I think it's better as it is. I'll just put some flowers in between or kind of around the inside of those bushes. Yeah, we'll do that. All right. Okay, so now we've gotta use some bone meal on these flowers here. Here in Babushka land, we have the finest bone meal in all the world. These flowers, they love this boner meal. Look how many flowers they make you give them boner meal. The only thing that loves this boner meal more than the flowers is your mother. Every time I give your mother her boner meal, she love it. She love it so much. Got some flowers. Okay, so that's that. It's good. I'm gonna fill in the area with some of these flowers. And let's do it. Right, lilac on the inside, peony, and we're good. Okay, now I'm gonna put a cherry sapling here and also one on the other side. It's either that these cherry trees will work or I'll end up designing my own cherry tree of some kind. Then in front of these guys, I think nothing might actually be the best answer. Might just put some flowers there or whatever, but yeah. Oh wow, is it just me or does that look like some evil happy, like some evil monster pink face? Like, yep, pretty good. So I've got to place some lights in the obvious spots, and then I'm gonna work on putting some of these shorter flowers. Blue, red, yellow, purple. That's what they're called. And daisies get an actual name. Yeah, why not? That's cute. Okay, then we got these inner areas, and we're set after that, eh? That's it. That's it. I kind of like the idea of using these purple guys. I like the way they look. They match Poseidon too, so I'm gonna rock with these right in front of him. Maybe I can make like a circular hedge that matches the inside of these like half circles facing into it. Yeah, I'll try that out. Try that out, see how it goes. And we'll do some sort of lilac peony pattern here, I think. Which one's taller? Lilac's taller, so we'll go lilac in the middle. Peony in the center. Or a peony on the outside. I like the idea of working with the landscape and also with how things kind of naturally play out. And then kind of adding my own symmetry, not my own, adding symmetry to that afterwards. But with this one, with this tree being like one tree and this one being kind of two trees. Oh yeah, there you go, two, right on the spot, right there. Okay, flying in, you know what? I like that. And it's a little bit wider and it matches the other side that's a little bit wider too. That's perfect. All right, that's it. That is the Babushka Land garden. Now I've just got to extend that dock out so that there's actually a way to get up there aside from that little that bullshit stairway with the scaffolding that I made there, and then I got to complete the sides and it's looking good. It's looking real good. So that's where we're at. I'm going to now put in some glowstone, and I'm also gonna decorate the ground with a lot of these cherry leaves or whatever, pink petals. So that's how it looks at night. I'm now going to proceed to remove all of the torches, and I'm going to put those pink petals that attach to the floor everywhere, like all over the place here. I'm going to kind of scatter them randomly, and I'll probably use a few stacks. So that's how I've updated my garden for today. My next step in this area is going to be to extend a dock out from that wooden plank area that leads to the front door. Anyway, thank you for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed it and have a nice day. Bye bye.